Good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome to worship on this sunny but chilly Sunday morning. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. I invite you to center yourself for worship as our choir blesses us with a call to worship. Beloved, opened the door to us. Through Jesus, you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcome. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promise prepared for us from the foundation of the world.
Amen.
And the stars begin to fall.
Give us the light we need and awaken us to the needs of others through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of God's Word. Just so you know, all these seats in the front are reserved.
Your harps, but let justice roll down like waters and word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will by no means precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with the cry of command, with the archangel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up in the clouds together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I invite you to rise and read the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel this morning comes to us from St. Matthew in the 25th chapter. Jesus said to the disciples, "And the kingdom of heaven will be like this. 10 bridesmaids took their lamps and went out to meet the bridegroom. 5 of them were foolish and 5 were wise. When the foolish took their lamps, they took no oil with them. But the wise took flasks of oil with their lamps. As the bridegroom was delayed, all of them became drowsy and slept. But at midnight there was a shout, 'Look, here comes the bridegroom. Come out to meet him.' And all those bridesmaids got up and trimmed their lamps. The foolish said to the wise, 'Give us some of your oil, for our lamps are going out.' But the wise replied, 'No, it will not be enough for you and for us. You had better go to the dealers and buy some for yourselves.' And while they went to buy it, the bridegroom came. And those who were ready went with him to the wedding banquet, and the door was shut. Later the other bridesmaids came also, saying, 'Lord, Lord, open to us.' But he replied, 'Truly I tell you, I do not know you. Keep awake, therefore, for you do need to know the day nor the hour.' This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to Christ.
Please be seated. I greet you with the grace, peace, mercy, and love poured into our lives by God our Creator and our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. I think I want to preach on Amos. No one ever preaches on prophets. You know why? They ruin our day. Prophets never have anything good to say from our standpoint. They speak for God usually when God is displeased with us, which could be quite often, present company included to the max. But it's something that has to be said, and I just kind of feel Amos this morning, keeping in theme what I've been talking about for the past 15 years, about justice. To get the full grasp of what's going on, I think we need to do a little bit of historical background. Amos was a prophet about 200 years after David's reign. When David became king, he united the monarchies of Israel and Judah into one monarchy, the United Monarchy. Israel being much larger kingdom to the north, Judah being the smaller monarchy to the south, but Jerusalem resides in Judah, and David was from Bethlehem, which is sort of a suburb of Jerusalem. And they remained united throughout Solomon's reign, his son, and then they broke apart. They broke apart, and the kingdom in the north, Israel, did things different than the kingdom in the south, Judah. The kingdom in the south, Judah, wanted to keep the lineage of David on the throne, while the people in the north, Israel, wanted someone like David to be their king. And so there was that schism. There were two different kings. Israel decided that they didn't think it was necessary for them to worship in the temple in Jerusalem. Instead, because they were much older and much wiser and had a different lineage, that they were going to worship in their holy places, in Bethel, in Gilgal, and in Beersheba, places that were historical importance to them, where Abraham dug his well, and where Jacob's ladder was. These became holy shrines in Israel. Amos comes along. Amos is a migrant farmer who lives in Judah. And he sees all that's going on in Israel, and he decides he's going to go up. Well, God tells him, you're going to go up and talk to these people, because what's happening there is that the needy are being abused by the greedy. There's a real schism in the structure of how their society works. The rich are getting richer on the backs of the poor. And so he's going to go up there and he's going to give them this message. And the message is what we hear. You're waiting for the day of the Lord? Be careful what you wish for. He doesn't like what you're doing. He goes on to say, I hate, I despise your festivals. You're doing things all wrong. You're not worshiping me. You've decided that you're going to have your own little cult and do things your way. And you're going to abuse my people. My poor people, my needy, are being abused by you, the greedy. Amos was not very popular in Israel delivering this message. And they tuned him out. They didn't want to hear it. And if you follow this story a little bit further, in a couple more hundred years, Assyria comes in and takes Israel into enslavement. They got what they deserved. They got pushed into time out. But for me, the real turning point in this is the last two verses here. And it says, let justice flow like a river, and righteousness like a never-ending stream. God wants us to be just. This text, incidentally, that little phrase that I just gave you, was so powerful and so important to Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. This is what he lifted up. This was his vision of what God was telling him as a prophet, that we as a society should strive for. That not take the rich and make them richer and the poor and make them poor, take the enslaved and enslave them even further, but to let justice reign. And we've been talking about this, and I'm sure you're sick and tired of hearing me say this, but you know what? I'm going to make you more sick and more tired, because this is what we need to hear. It may not be what we want to hear, but we need to understand that gathering here on a Sunday morning, while it's wonderful and nice and I love to see all your faces, this is not a faith where we work for 59 minutes a week. We are 24/7, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. We need to live this life of justice and righteousness, and not forget about it when we walk out this door. Because if we do, then God will tell us, I hate your festivals, I hate your worship, because you're not doing what I want you to do. We are called as people of God to be just. We are called, just as it says in Micah, in Micah 6, it says that what does God require of us is that we act justly, we love mercy, and we walk humbly with our God. It's not about all the trappings. It's about what's going on the inside. We need to understand. And if we're not living a life of justice and kindness and mercy, then we need to rethink that and find ways that we can do that. We need to forget about all the trappings that we find in our worship. And we need to go to where that flowing river and flowing streams, and we need to stand underneath it and bathe in it and let God wash us away, wash our sins away, and cleanse us so that we can be God's hands and hearts in this world. We can understand what Dr. King was saying. We can understand what Amos was saying. It's not about what it looks like on the outside. It's only about what's going on the inside. Love justice. Act righteously. Care for God's people. Don't abuse God's people.
Amen.
Thank you.
Friday today and we have no Sunday school teacher. So why don't you come up and we'll have a little story. Come on, Ava and Rayanne and Aaron, come on up. Mommies and daddies are allowed to come up too if they have to carry kids. Hi Ava, how are you?
You can tell that I'm not a fly. You can
Bless citizens with wise leaders. Save your children from war. We pray for the veterans of this community that they are supported and loved. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
O God, in whom we hope, we pray for all who are needy. Provide for those who experience homelessness or hunger. Support the under or underemployed. And comfort any who are suffering this day. Especially Krista, Teresa, Shirley, Christine, Jimmy, George, John, Neville, Doreen, Sean, and Sabrina, Bob, Robert, Peggy, Gina, Jennifer, Pastor Lee, Kristen, Vicki, Aubrey, and those we name before you. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
O God, for whom we listen, inspire the music ministry of our congregation. Fill our worship with songs to proclaim your greatness. Help us sing and dance with joy and tell boldly of your salvation. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
For what else will the church pray for this morning?
We pray today for all those struggling with substance abuse. May your light shine upon them and show them the strength that they have within themselves to win this battle.
We pray for peace in our planet and justice in our hearts.
O God, in whom we remain, we remember our loved ones who have died and now live in you. Bring comfort and the assurance of new life to all who grieve. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
We offer our spoken prayers and those held in our hearts, trusting in your mercy, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
And now may the peace of the Lord, a peace that surpasses all human understanding, be with you all. Let us share God's amazing peace with one another.
Thank you.
thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who rose beyond the bounds of death and on this day as he has promised, poured out your spirit of life and power upon the chosen disciples. At this the whole earth exalts in boundless joy. And so with the church on earth and the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. In the night that he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, and he blessed it, and he broke it, and he gave it to the disciples, and he said, take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And again, after supper, he took the cup, and he blessed it, and he passed it around to the disciples, and he said, drink from this, all of you. This cup is a new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you and to all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me. Remembering therefore his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out your Holy Spirit, that by this holy communion we may know the unity we share with all your people in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now gathered with God's Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Please be seated while our choir blesses us today. God who takes away the sin of the world, happy are we who are called to this supper. Now, God be the Christ is with us to the end of the age. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Thank you. strengthen us and keep us forever in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, on the abundance table, you have refreshed our hearts in this meal with bread for the journey. Give us your grace on the road that we may serve our neighbors with joy. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Please be seated for this morning's announcements. So happy birthday to Jimmy Jenkins. Wherever you are, Jimmy, hanging out in Kings Park, happy birthday. All the flowers this morning are given by Barbara Rizzo in memory of her parents' wedding anniversary and in honor of all our veterans. Tonight, drum roll, at 6 o'clock, right here, our amazing concert. And the difference between then and now, because it's going to be dark, is the front seats will be taken. You guys will sit in the front here. So we have 18 great acts and one other act. I'm doing one. So come out, it'll be a lot of fun, and it's a fundraiser for our scholarship fund. So we hope to get some more money that we can send our kids to college, and hopefully they'll come back. The prayer garden, you can actually see it from the windows now. There's still some bloom there. It's coming along very nicely. We're just waiting for the cross to be delivered. And once that's in, we'll have a dedication out there. Senior luncheon this week at 12:30. 7:30 on Thursday is Bible study. We continue in the book of Galatians. Next week is our council meeting after worship. And on the 21st, that's the Tuesday before Thanksgiving, we're going to be having a Share Your Gifts Day. We're going to invite the community to come in. We're going to give them free clothing and free food during our senior luncheon. So if we can use some more donations of non-perishable food items, you can drop them in the baskets outside. And the 26th, 2 weeks from today, we're having our first Praise Music Sunday. And it's going to be a little bit different worship. We're going to be doing more songs, some songs that you may have heard as anthems around here and there. I think we're going to try to project that onto screens rather than have a bulletin. We're going to have a totally different kind of worship, taking a different feel to it. And I might even preach once, but you never know. And then on the 2nd of December, Lori has invited everybody to her house to spend the weekend. for a Christmas celebration. She's not too far from here, right here on Marcus. We have the RSVP, that's responding to a single play. Okay. Just to show you that right now, to be frank. I have a little fresh list we don't play. I'm great, right? Anyway, on the 25th. So, and also, Angela is having, continuing her show, her exhibition at the Barnes Art Gallery, the Upcycled Artwork. Please have the chance to stop in and see her work. And if you're so inclined to buy some of her work, it's all available for purchase. And that's all I got. Make sure you come tonight at 6 o'clock.
And dress up if you want.
And dress up. Some of us will be in costume. Please rise. You know what? I need the kids to help me. I haven't had the kids help me in a long time. Come on up, kids. Amy, you want to come back up? It's always better when you have kids helping, don't you think? Well, here comes that big kid, too. Okay, so your job is to stand on that step, turn around and face everybody, because the cute factor is what we're after here. Okay, we're going to raise our hands like this. Now may the Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face to shine upon us and be gracious to us. The Lord look upon us with favor and grant us peace.
Amen.
Now we're going to turn. Over the back. Very good. Thank you. That was great. Cute factor. You're allowed to clap. You're
I'm trying.